Since the start of Corona lockdown in India, many TV channels and social media sites have been claiming that the Tablighi Jamaat and the Muslim community has been responsible for the spread of COVID-19 epidemic. They say that Muslims deliberately spread the virus, misbehaved with the doctors, and they're all traitors, jihadis, and so on. Any news is considered trustworthy if it shows the point of view of both the sides. It is true that between March 13th and 15th this year, over 3,000 members of the Tablighi Jamaat, a Muslim religious group, gathered in its Delhi headquarters when COVID-19 was spreading in India. They should not have done that, and their gathering may have led to further spread of the disease. But due to the lockdown, they could not leave from there and were able to exit only at the end of March. But then started a big campaign by most of the TV channels and social media sites to blame and malign not only the Tablighis but the entire Muslim community with the most insulting and abusive sentences and slur. So much so that the entire India started seeing Muslims as the only carriers of COVID-19 and everyone's enemies.
Tablighi Jamaat ka chehra benakab karne wali ye exclusive report.
Dharm ke naam par mano bomb bhej do, corona bomb bhej do.
Ordinary Muslims were attacked in many places. Muslim vegetable and fruit sellers were boycotted everywhere. And the hateful propaganda of many TV channels against Muslims continues unabated.
Jamaat ke log aspatal mein hangama kar rahe hain.
Unfortunately, most of the news items blaming them for this bad behavior are turning out to be false or fabricated. Let us see. We all know that the COVID-19 virus came from outside India. According to the Government of India's Cabinet Secretary, some 15 lakh or 1.5 million people arrived into India from outside between 8th January and 24th March. Now, out of the 3,000 people who attended Tablighi Jamaat, hardly 500 may have been foreigners. So why doesn't anyone talk about the other 1.49 million people? They must have also been tested, held responsible for some spread of COVID and must have been quarantined. Why was only one group or community held responsible for the spread of this virus? Doesn't it show the communal prejudice that much of Indian media holds for the Muslims?
Sochiye kitne bade paimane par sankraman ka khatra is waqt Bharat mein.
Look at these examples. News came from Chhattisgarh that Tablighi members in a hospital are spitting on and misbehaving with the medical staff. This news was spread by India Today, Deccan Herald, Economic Times, ABP Live, Op India and a BJP MP. But later, an official from Raipur's AIIMS tweeted that the Tablighi patients from Korba did not spit on or misbehave with anyone. So the news was false. A video went viral showing a bearded man in a police van spitting on a policeman and other constables attacking him. It was claimed that this man was a Tablighi, but later it was revealed that the video was from Maharashtra's Thane and dated February. Mumbai Mirror reported that this 26-year-old suspect spat on the police because they did not allow him to eat the food brought from his home. It had nothing to do with the coronavirus or Tablighis. Z News tweeted and Op India mentioned that in Firozabad, UP, four Tablighis who were corona positive threw stones on the medical team. But the police officials from Firozabad clarified that this news is false. No one threw stones on an ambulance or medical team in Firozabad. Z News immediately deleted its tweet. Karnataka's BJP MP Shobha Karandlaje said that in Belagavi, Karnataka, the Tablighis are dancing, spitting on medical staff and misbehaving with them. But Belagavi's Deputy Commissioner S.B. Bommanhalli declared this news as false and said that no one quarantined in the entire district spat or misbehaved with anyone. By the way, a case of false tweeting had been filed on the same Shobha Karandlaje last January in Kerala. From Saharanpur, UP, Amar Ujala, News India, Patrika and Op India etc. claimed that when Tablighis did not get non-vegetarian food, they threw the food and defecated in the open. But the Saharanpur police later rejected this news as fake. Many channels and social media showed that a Muslim fruit seller is spitting on fruits to spread the virus. But the alt news investigated this and found it to be an old video from Raisen, Madhya Pradesh, where there were no corona cases. Raisen's police officials also clarified this.
So, jahan se pata chala, ye kafi purana video hai.
Navbharat Times, Patrika and Deepak Chaurasia said that during an argument connecting coronavirus with Tablighi Jamaat in Prayagraj, a young man was shot dead. But the Prayagraj police denounced this news and said that this attack had nothing to do with Tablighi Jamaat. A video going viral on social media showed that many Muslims are licking food utensils with their tongues in order to spread the virus. But the alt news found that this is an old video showing Daudi Bohra Muslims who do not like leaving any food in the plates and are licking the utensils to clean them in 2018. Another viral video showed that many Muslims in a gathering are vigorously sneezing together to spread the virus. In reality, this is a ritual of the Sufis where they chant a prayer and breathe in and out together. This is probably an old video from Pakistan. Another video that spread a lot after the Tablighi incident shows a Muslim-looking man in a restaurant kitchen blowing air into many food packets. The alt news investigated this and said that it is not from India. It is about a year old and probably from a restaurant in Singapore. On 14th April, when hundreds of workers gathered at Mumbai's Bandra station after a rumor that train service is going to start and they'll be able to return home, many TV channels announced that a mosque near the station is responsible for gathering the crowd, which was not true.
Police ki jo gaadiyon ke paas jo unke megaphones hote hain, unse wo apni baat unko pahuncha nahi pa rahe the, matlab unki awaaz nahi ja rahi thi, to unhone masjid mein request kiya ki hum masjid se announcement karenge.
In the middle of corona lockdown, many other religious ceremonies were held all over India where hundreds of people gathered, but the media ignored most of them and targeted only Tablighi Jamaat and Muslims.
Unko jis tarah se pracharit kiya ja raha hai, mano wo aatankwadi hon.
So friends, you saw how our irresponsible media can fabricate false news and defame whichever community it wants to. It can easily spread hatred and violence. We don't claim that all the news are false or fake, some may even be true, but if you wish to keep India peaceful and avoid the Hindu-Muslim conflict, please beware of these irresponsible TV channels. We need to scrutinize and test every news that comes out for its authenticity before we believe it. Neither watch nor share any fake or hateful news that comes to you. Jai Hind!